this is after surgery. It's okay, sweetheart. Okay, so today is Tuesday, and right now I'm going into Target because I need to buy some last minute things before surgery. So I'm probably just coming in here, I'm trying to find a fold up table because I can't really reach, so I need to have the table closer to my bed or whatever. Then I'm gonna get like a little bit of groceries because I'm gonna need some food. Cause I'm not gonna be able to go out and go get my own food. I probably still order food, but yeah. So that's what I'm about to do. About to go in to Target and get these things. I'm looking for ones that don't have no wires in them. Oh, that's a sports bra. Wow. Either snap or zipper up the, at the front. I'm annoyed. Because you guys said that you had them. I don't know if it was just online. This is really a burnout. Oh my god. I'm fucking irritated now. Let's try to find at least something else I came here for. Super tough. Love that. All right. Ooh. Where? I feel like this is small.
That one, that's a personal table right there.
Really? I don't know how much that one is. Like, I don't know, can you see it? A little table. So when, so I don't have to reach all far because my bed is a little bit high. Well, on the higher side. So don't mind my lips. I just had a blueberry water ice from Fez. I'm like, yo, I want a water ice. So my friend can pick me up when we went to Fred's. Tabletop. It's bigger than what I thought it was gonna be. I really wanted it something a little smaller, but I guess this is okay for the most part. But yeah, I got some groceries from Target as well. I got stuff like Gatorades because I think that's good for me to keep myself hydrated and all that extra stuff. First of all, how does this go? I don't understand. Hold up, wait a minute. Maybe. Okay, so this is the tabletop. Only got it for $19.99, y'all. I'm so freaking happy. I don't feel like spending no damn $40 on a little ass table. So, yeah. And it's sturdy. It's sturdy. Basically, it's gonna go right here. Yep. Hey, guys. So, today is Thursday, the night before my surgery. It's almost, what time is it? I think it's like 11 something. It's almost that time where I can't eat anything after 12. So I'm trying to like get my last minute snacks in. Yeah. I'm worried about that. But she didn't even drink a cup of water after 12. That's on my dick. But yeah, I got my hair done today. It's like super cute. I just didn't want to have to worry about my hair for like 2.5 weeks. Well, I gotta make them last for 3 weeks. But yeah, I got some last minute things. I got me some a case of water. I had to pick up my antibiotics for, you know, post-surgery. Whatever. And I also got this, what is it, like a body pillow? I don't know. I had to get, I got it from Target for like $18, so that was cool. And my ear just like went numb. That's crazy. But anyways, so I can't have any type of like when I wash up. I was thinking I was gonna wash up tonight, but then again I might just wait till morning time so I could wake myself up. Well, when I take a shower, I can't like do like my normal thing, like put some lotion on or deodorant or spray myself or wear any jewelry, because can't wear jewelry during surgery. They're gonna make you take it off anyway, so it's pointless to like come there with necklaces and rings and earrings. That's all big and everything. So yeah, I'm just so excited, guys. Like, this is finally happening after wanting this for so long. Like, literally having big boobs is not what it's cracked up to be. Everybody keep paying for these big boobs. Y'all don't even know the daily struggles with it. Like, it's not fun. It's not cute to me personally. I just had a lot of insecurities with it, in a way. Even though everybody be like, oh my God, your boobs, they are so big, but they look so good. Don't get a breast reduction. But it's my decision, and I'm the one that's living with it. So I'm the one that have to go through the daily things or whatever. As far as having big boobs, it's just really annoying. But I don't even know my, it's so bad, I haven't even been shopping for bras. Like, I don't shop for bras, so I don't even know my bra size. Like, when I went in there for my consultation, they're like, so yeah, what's your bra size or whatever? I'm like, yeah, I don't know. Would be able to tell you. I'm just so happy, because like, now I'm going to be able to wear all the stuff that I want to wear. Oh my God, I can't wait to go bra shopping, bathing suit shopping, because baby, it's up the summer. Boobs is the first step. I'm going to be working out and take y'all on my journey too, because I'm trying to lose like 20 pounds for real, because I am fat, okay? My hair is really cute. I really like these. I messed up the edges because I took a nap earlier, but that's cool. I need my appointment at 8:45 in the morning. So damn early. And as you know, like, this type of procedure is like an outpatient procedure, meaning like I can go home the same day. So I'll be coming home the same day after my surgery. And yeah, so when I take a shower, I can't put on deodorant, like I said, or lotion my body down, or I'll be ashy. But yeah, I was gonna be extra and really have like a whole full face, like, because I'm really that extra, but it's really no point. It's really no point of me putting on makeup. Like, that would just be playing too much. But yeah, I just finished my homework. I'm trying to get all my homework done before the surgery, because I know the first couple of days I'm going to be like sore, so I probably just want to lay down and chill, watch TV. Like, I'm not gonna have to worry about, oh my God, I'm not gonna be worrying about having to do schoolwork. Oh, and I also got my nails taken off, because I just didn't want to have those long nails on, like, soon as I got this operation. Probably like 3 weeks, I'll probably get back my long nails, but I just needed to get some color on my nails. Gel polish. I didn't even get acrylic or nothing. But yeah, I'm so excited. I can't wait to bring you guys. I can't even, you know how they be tripping about recording in the hospitals, but I'm gonna record for y'all. Like, I'm like kind of nervous, but I know everything's gonna go well. I said a prayer before I went to bed last night. I'll probably see another one today. And yeah, so I'll talk to you guys tomorrow, and we're gonna get into it, period. Good morning. So I just woke up to what, like 6-7 o'clock in the morning. My surgery is not till like 8:45, so I'm so glad I almost overslept, y'all. I'm so tired. Flashing, had you shoot it up from your head to the ground. Beat it up, beat it up. Told you I'm on the way, so you heat it up. Said you don't wanna go too fast, so ease it up. Didn't think you would wanna go freezing up. Out of gate with all, out of gate of sauce. Out of gate of park, key to the house, key to the car. Then we can take it too far. I would've gave you my heart. But it's a long shot now, we can't get along not now. Drew, let it start over back, how? Blood, sweat, tears, no fire. I'm at the facility where I'm about to get my surgery. Say goodbye to these, because they are going, period. By 8:30, so. Yeah. That's what I'm about to do. Wait on my mom. People so annoying. I can't. But yeah.
Is the child locked on? Let's go to suite 120. Oh. I know.
Jenkins. Do you want me? Okay. Your temperature? Yeah. Alright. How are you?
I'm
fine. Did your insurance card and your ID, please?
Yes.
And who's driving home today?
My mom.
Number?
267-504.
And your name?
Tamika, T-A-M-I-K-A.
Your daughter?
No, that's my niece. No kids. Mm-mm. Oh, man. I don't think I have any. I have two nieces and a nephew.
There you go. You can take them home, spoil them, mm-hmm. Take them home.
I take them right back. Home.
This is 115-98?
Yes.
You're on 16th Street?
Yes. Thank you. Did I put the date?
Yep, put the date right there.
Crack it up. Y'all, she a sucker. Look at Autumn. What's she doing? Autumn.
You have no bun in the oven.
Oh, heck no. You gotta do stuff to do that.
If you can just give 3 drops.
Gotta see if I ain't having no kids. But y'all know I'm not.
You wanna take her now? You can take her now. Yeah.
Right now. Walmart before the ID and stuff. Everything off.
Okay.
Everything. Good morning.
Good morning. Shoes. Coming out.
There she is.
Here she is. Oh, my baby. Hi.
She's her mom. Today's going to be rough.
Oh, this is after surgery. It's okay, sweetheart. I love you. I am. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. And we're just going to do the lap, okay? Because I don't want it on your surgical area. Okay, let's just do the lap. All right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. You take care.
Good Thank day. You, ladies. Bye. Have a good day.
Thank you. I'm so cold. Oh, my boobs hurt so bad.
Oh, no.
Turn the heat on, please.
Okay.
I wish I had a pillow right now. This is crazy. Do they look smaller? This is crazy.
Oh, no.
My boobs hurt so bad. I just want to get in my bed. I'm hungry.
How you doing? You okay?
I'm okay. It's just like a burning sensation. Somebody's calling you.
Oh, it's okay. They can leave a message.
Let's just hurry up and get home.
Okay.
You can record me later.
Okay.
So, here's an update, guys. I think it's like 4 o'clock. Child. That fucking pain. My boobs was hurting so bad. Like, it was like this burning. Like, when I first woke up from my anesthesia, it was like this burning sensation. Like somebody gave me rug burn. Like, it was, oh my, it was excruciating. They had to give me two Percocets. But they did not kick in right away. Like, they kicked in like 25 minutes later when I was already in the car going home. Like, I was crying and everything. I don't do well with coming up from anesthesia. That's just me. I can't do well with pain or none of that. Like, I'm a crybaby when it comes to stuff like that. I was just out of it. I'm like, where's my mom? Crying and stuff, but like right now I'm feeling a little bit better. It's like really, it's just like sore now. I got like this ice pack in case the burning sensation come back, and I'm also just like icing a little bit so it can like numb it, I guess, and don't hurt so much. But I just ate some soup. I got my like little medical table set up. I just took my antibiotics. Yeah. I'm just trying to keep myself hydrated. And I think I'm getting tired again. Probably because I got the itis. Like, you know how black people is when they eat. Oh my God. Right now I'm just watching TV and I'm just chilling out. My mom went to the store. Well, went to CVS to pick up my prescription because they forgot to prescribe me the narcotics to take home, and I need that because that pain, it's starting to come back a little bit now because like it wore off. I came home at like, I got out of surgery, I think like 12 something or whatever, so that's when I had took them, and they wearing off because the pain is starting to come. But it's not like excruciating how it was earlier. It's like more subtle now, like more faint. And I had to have help going to the bathroom, but I felt really sick, like really nauseous. Like I felt like I had to
throw up. Like, you know how you might have a night of party and you really drunk and all that, and just feel like you sick, the room is spinning, like you gotta throw up. That's exactly how I felt like when I got up, the room was spinning. So my mom made me like sit down because she like didn't want me to pass out or anything like that. But yeah, I'm set up. I got like my little wedge pillow. I don't know if you can see it. I got these two pillows and I'm really comfortable because I got this new memory foam bed. It's so soft, like, so I'm happy about that. And it's going good. I feel so much better than how I felt earlier. You know, just sore, like I said, but I don't know if you guys can see how they look a little bit. This is like literally a major difference. Like, wow. I can't believe that I really got it. It's finally here. I'm super excited. I just keep thinking about all the clothes I'm gonna buy. Ugh, I'm so happy about that. But yeah. I'll probably talk to you guys a little bit later because I'm getting tired.
Wait, hold on. I'm not sure this is gonna work.
I think I wanna take a nap. So, yeah. So I just woke up. I'm feeling a lot better. My mom had got my other medicine from CVS, and I'm actually sleeping surprisingly comfortable. I thought I was going to be like having troubles or whatever. Probably talk to you guys tomorrow. I'm hungry again. I don't know what I'm going to eat. Good morning, guys. So, I just woke up. Oof. Ouch. It's like really aching. I just took two of my antibiotics. But I need to wait to eat something before I take my narcotics. Ooh, I just woke up in like some pain. It's like sore. It's like shooting pain a little bit. I can like go to the bathroom by myself and stuff, but I've been needing help getting in and out of the bed. I actually got a good night's sleep. I have a pillow right here to keep my arm elevated. This is the mark from when they were writing on my boobs. Everybody was like, what is that? Thank goodness I did all of my homework. So I don't have to do no homework this weekend. They said like the first 3 days is gonna be like the most crucial. So yeah. I'm like totally happy. Like my boobs are so small now, y'all. Like this is crazy. I didn't think, like, I'm still in shock, like, wow, you got your boobs done yesterday. What the heck? It's crazy. But yeah, so I'll talk to you guys later. I'm gonna eat some breakfast and then watch a movie. Probably watch, well, right now I'm watching I Am Legend with Will Smith. If you haven't watched that movie, you should watch it. It's really good.
People,
I'm in here.
I think people,
and him bothering me.
I think people
while we watching TV.
I think people's spirits jump on you. I'm
you see her? She's talking and reading. She's supposed to be doing her homework. And she's in here watching TV, trying to preach to me.
Because I look like my mom with my glasses on. Dang.
Mom, you are somebody's mom. What are you talking about?
I got my
bonnet
on. Like,
I got my bonnet on too. Look at this dweeb that came to see me.
No, I'm not mad at that at all.
Look at her. She don't even know she's on camera.
Okay.
You're such a goofball. What do you want from me? Oh, please. Someone tell her to get out of here.
No.
She coming in here trying to mess with me and mess with my new boobs.
And mess with my new boobs.
Really?
Hey. Oh, ouch. Ah, fuck. Well, today is Monday. I did not record yesterday because this just wasn't a good day. I was hurting so bad. My back was hurting. My butt was hurting. I was just so uncomfortable. But yeah. I'm feeling a little bit better, but my chest is like really freaking sore. Like, I feel like I've been hit by Mack trucks. Like, oof.
Oh Lord, I made my appointment for my post-op appointment. I think it's on the 15th. I was like in and out of sleep all day today. I didn't even make it to my online class. I can't. I didn't feel like it. Since I'm hurting so much, my mom's scared. She don't really want me to take a shower. So I'll probably take one tomorrow. Whatever.
Yeah, this is how they look. My stomach's bloated from the anesthesia still. I feel like I'm pregnant. I still got the marks and stuff. They're really small now, guys. Look. Yeah. This is crazy. But I'm happy. So, looks crooked. My mom has had to fix it a little bit because it kept stabbing me. No, I'm recording. It kept stabbing me right here. So when I take a shower, I'll probably have to scrub to get these marks off me. I'm happy with my results. Don't tell me what to do.
Good afternoon. This is not day four, mom.
Day six.
Almost a week. So today is Thursday. This is my 1 week post-op appointment. And I'm on my way. So yesterday I took a shower and everything. My mom had to wrap me in plastic wrap. I wish I recorded for y'all, but it was hurting because my sports bra, well, the bra they gave me to go home in, whatever, my recovery bra, it was too freaking tight. And it made like marks on my back. It broke skin and it was hurting. So, yeah, I was being a big baby and I was crying. So, let's not gonna report that. Today's a better day. Yesterday was just not a good day. I couldn't get nothing to eat. It was just no. But yeah, watch out. See, my mom dropped like a race car driver. She's trying to kill me. Like, Jesus, mom.
It's the bumps in the road.
Lady.
Stop being a baby.
No, get on the other side because I'm going to be. So, stay tuned. Cafeteria. The thing she bought me this. And a muffin, a banana nut muffin. Because I want Chick-fil-A and I'm not trying to spoil my appetite. I do feel sick though. I don't know because I didn't really get a good meal. And my mom ain't cooked for me. Not once.
And then one time you cooked for me when I was
dead. I did cook for you. Yes, I did. Yes, I did, because I was cooking meals. Like, what? So aggy.
So scoop back all the way here. All right, and then we're going to put your legs up here. And then I'm just going to, like, tilt you back so the back of your chair goes down a little. So, taking the bandages off is pretty easy. So, like how that was digging into you, don't want, especially like in the front here where your incisions are, okay?
Just get a sports bra to zipper up in the front.
Yes, something that zips in
like
the front.
Yeah, like a nice material.
Yeah, nice and soft and like something similar to how that, but just. Cotton, soft, stretchy.
That's not Target. That's my
favorite. Target, yeah. Target or Walmart, really.
Yeah.
And stretchy, roomy, no underwires.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Just something comfortable that's not smushing your breast.
Right.
Okay. Ooh. So even if you have to buy it a little big. Sorry. I'm going to start to peel everything back.
Okay.
Everything, like so far, everything looks perfect.
Okay.
We're going to take a look at all your You're not excited about this, are you?
No. I tried to get the marks off.
You know what? And they're going to take time because those markers are hard to get off. You okay so far?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Easier than I thought.
Yep. And now this one over the nipple sometimes feels a little weird.
Oh, Lord.
But it's just, it is what it is. We got to just peel it back. So you might feel like I'm pulling your nipple off. I promise you I'm not. So far, so good. Everything looks really good.
I was hoping on my
car, but it wasn't. No, you didn't. It looks great. Everything's, you know, there's a little swelling and bruising, which right. is normal dried, scabby blood. Say, it oozes a little. So it's just this arm down a little bit for me. What you can do now is when you shower next time, you're going to wash with soap and water over all your incisions.
Okay.
And then you'll dry off. And puts a brow on and just put some simple pads down in there to keep protection there.
What type of pads?
So you could use, a lot of our patients use the sanitary maxi pads.
Okay.
You know, the ones you would use if your period is really heavy?
Yeah.
But your mom may want to, because she's in the medical field and she might be particular like I would be, buy some gauze at CVS or something.
Oh yeah, that's what she was thinking about.
But gauze is fine too, but whatever works for you. I'll give you some to put on today before you go. This looks really good. Everything looks perfect. All your bandages are off. And you have a little bit of swelling on the sides, which is normal. A little bit of swelling throughout. But let's sit you up and you can, if you want, you can go look like in the mirror. Does it feel better to have?
Mom, come on. I wish she'd come on. Oh my God. This lady don't know when to stop.
God and do all things above me. The things I can't change are the reason you love me. Listen, you can hear them calling my name. I'm all over the place. I can't sit in one place. I'm not ashamed at all. Still finding myself.
Oh. Can you pick that up for me, please?
Okay.
Stop playing. This one is a 38C.
She's trying to make me get this small size.
It is. That's your boobies.
I think I should go up at least to a D. Just for the meantime. Because I don't want nothing too.
Okay.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Okay. Get a D.
Because these are the sports bras, and you know they.
All right. Well, get a 38D then. Okay.
Let's see this. Now, see? And I got to put those gauze in there and stuff.
Okay, yeah. Get that.
I'm going to go with this one. I end up going freaking shopping for stuff. Ah! I'm trying to get some beefaroni. I got a lot of soup because I love soup.
I love beefaroni. Hey
guys, I don't know if you can hear me. My freaking fan is so loud. Like, it's like one of those power fans. So excuse me if you can hardly hear me. I'm gonna try to speak up a little louder. It's like, no. But yeah, I just came from getting something to eat. Well, Target, and then going to Chick-fil-A. I still gotta eat my sandwich. It's my appointment. She told me to like wash every day. Wash every day with soap, like sensitive type of soap, and then like pad dry the incisions where the incisions are. So I'm gonna do that every day, and I can't put any ointment on her yet, but you know, soon as I'm in the clear, I'm gonna be buying all this type of moisturizers because I need these scars to go, okay? Summer is right around the corner. It's crazy, but yeah, I don't go back until like May something, like 3 weeks from now. And I was actually able to walk. It felt like a relief when she took those like the bandages and all and everything like that, because like now I feel like I can like move a little bit more. I was a little bit scared when I had it and it was like hurting, but yeah, girl, oh my god, y'all, I truly recommend getting it if this is what you really, 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 if this is what you really want and need, okay? It's a must. But if you're just trying to do it just to do it or whatever, or you don't really want it, or you're not sure, or you're scared, don't do it, mama. Because the pain, I'm not going to sugarcoat, hurt like shit. I still get these little, like pins and needles type of feelings, like, woof. So I'm going to go ahead and eat, watch my show, Degrassi. I don't know if y'all watch that, but that's classic, and I'm starting over from the beginning, okay, season one. Anyways, but yeah, it was just, it's a good experience, and I'm happy I got it done. I'm just ready to see the process of the healing and me being able to get back to doing normal activities and stuff like that. So yes, thank you for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I will be updating you guys on this process. Yeah, thank you for watching, and yeah.